Hi, welcome back to Travel Destination. All over the world, there are hundreds of UNESCO World Heritage sites. These are so crucial to our society that they're protected for future generations to enjoy. Africa has 89 heritage sites that feature some of the world's most fascinating and breathtaking places to visit. Some are famous, like the Great Pyramids of Egypt, while others are far less visited but just as spectacular. Here are 10 incredible UNESCO World Heritage sites in Africa. 1. Rock-hewn churches of Lalibela, Ethiopia. The remote mountain village of Lalibela town in northern Ethiopia is home to 11 spectacular medieval churches and are carved, inside and out, from a single rock. These mystic creations have turned this mountain town into a place of pride and pilgrimage for worshippers and visitors alike. These churches represent a building tradition that has been used in Ethiopia since the 6th century, but these particular churches are attributed to King Lalibela, who ruled in the 13th century. The king had a vision of a new Jerusalem for Christians who couldn't make the pilgrimage to the Holy Land because of Muslim conquests across North Africa. The best time to go is during Timkit, a festival in January that marks the Epiphany, where Ethiopian Christians reenact the baptism of Christ. 2. Mount Kilimanjaro, Tanzania. Mount Kilimanjaro, Africa's highest point, stands proudly with its snowy peak looming above the surrounding plains. The mountain is surrounded by forests and some of the most amazing animals found on the continent. Climbers of Kilimanjaro will be rewarded with awe-inspiring views of the surrounding savanna and glimpses of permanent glaciers and impressive ice cliffs. Weather permitting, hikers with average skill and equipment can make the climb in just a few hours. There are also plenty of great outfitters who will take you on the climb of a lifetime. Kilimanjaro National Park, covering an area of some 75,575 ha, protects the largest freestanding volcanic mass in the world and the highest mountain in Africa, rising 4877 m above surrounding plains to 5895 m at its peak. With its snow-capped peak, the Kilimanjaro is a superlative natural phenomenon. Standing in isolation above the surrounding plains overlooking the savanna, 3 cliffs of Bandiagara, Mali. Mali is full of extraordinary architecture and is home to 2 great UNESCO sites. The first belongs to the Dogons that live along the Bandiagara escarpment. They have built an incredible cliffside settlement of houses, granaries, altars, and sanctuaries called the Land of the Dogons. This expansive region of 289 villages was erected in the 15th century. They soar 1,000 feet up the cliffs and stretch for nearly 100 miles across this ancient land. The settlement was built as a natural fortress to defend the Dogon people, allowing them to conserve their centuries-old culture and traditions. Be prepared for a trip without the luxuries of modern hotels and amenities if you visit this amazing site, but you won't regret it. 4. Ruins of Carthage, Tunisia. You'll find the ancient UNESCO site of Carthage on a hilly outcrop overlooking the Mediterranean Sea, just 9 miles from Tunis. Carthage became a vibrant port city in 814 BC when the maritime Phoenician explorers came to the region to set up trade. Carthage fell to the Romans in 44 BC during the rule of Julius Caesar, and then by Vandals, Byzantines, and finally Arabs, before eventually falling into obscurity in the 7th century AD. The ruins are one of Tunisia's most popular tourist sites, and history lovers will fall in love with the museums and excavation sites of one of the world's most famous port cities. Don't miss the Roman Amphitheater and Antoine Baths. They are incredible. 5. Timbuktu, Mali. Timbuktu is not just a place your mother threatened to send you when you misbehaved, it's really a place. Even though this ancient city in West Africa has seen its glory days between the 13th and 16th centuries, Timbuktu was the seat of grand Islamic scholarship. This majestic mosque is made of mud and timber and was used to house sacred Muslim texts for scholars to study. Timbuktu was also an oasis for the camel caravans that snaked across the Sahara, plying the salt trade. Back then, salt was traded pound for pound with gold because that was the only way food could be preserved. Travel to Mali requires some planning, so make sure to invest in an established tour company before you head out. Home of the prestigious Quranic Sankore University and other madrasas, Timbuktu was an intellectual and spiritual capital and a center for the propagation of Islam throughout Africa in the 15th and 16th centuries. Its three great mosques, Jingareba, Sankore, and Sidi Yahya, recall Timbuktu's golden age. Although continuously restored, these monuments are today under threat from desertification. 6. Limestone Forest of Tsingy, Delaware, Bemaraha, Madagascar. The African island of Madagascar is more than a place to gaze at the unique ring-tailed lemur. There is another unusual sight that you must include on your itinerary, the limestone needle forests of Tsingy. You'll find that Mother Nature has worked her magic, and the effects of erosion have formed a geological oddity. The weird shapes of these rifts have created their own ecosystem, and the undisturbed forests, lakes, and mangrove swamps of northern Madagascar are the habitat for rare and endangered lemurs and birds. This epic journey will take you off a beaten path, and more than likely, you'll have the place to yourself. 7. Ancient Thebes, Egypt. If you want to get away from the crowds of Cairo and see some real Egyptian history, then just head south to the city of Luxor, home to the awesome UNESCO site of ancient Thebes. Luxor was once an ancient Egyptian capital, but today is known as the world's greatest open-air museum. From the tomb of Tutankhamun in the Valley of the Kings to the magnificent sunset views at the majestic temple complexes of Luxor and Seti, Luxor has it all. To see the Nile like a pharaoh, take an exciting Nile cruise. After a day touring the ruins, take in an evening sight and sound show at the Karnak Temple. 8. Medina of Marrakesh, Morocco. If you want to explore the magical Red City of Morocco, then visit Marrakesh. The Medina is one of Morocco's most visited UNESCO sites, and you'll be captivated by the seemingly unending markets, souks, gardens, and historic sites of the Medina. There is so much more to see in this vibrant city besides rugs, brass, and lanterns. The city is home to the lively Jema El Fna, a square filled with storytellers, acrobats, dancers, and musicians. A bit further from the square are the heritage sites themselves, including the Grand Ben Yosef Mosque and the El Badi and Bahia palaces that show off one of the most striking features of the Moroccan architecture: zellige or mosaics design using hand-cut tiles. Founded in 1070-72 by the Almoravids, Marrakesh remained a political, economic and cultural center for a long period. Its influence was felt throughout the Western Muslim world, from North Africa to Andalusia. It has several impressive monuments dating from that period: the Kutubia Mosque, the Kasbah, the battlements, monumental doors, gardens, etc. Later architectural jewels include the Bandiya Palace, the Ben Yosef Madrasa, the Saudian tombs, several great residences, and Place Jama El Fna, a veritable open-air theater. 9. Great Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe, once the capital of an ancient trading empire, Great Zimbabwe is found in the southeastern hills of what is now the country of Zimbabwe. Even though these ruins are not as stunning as other UNESCO sites in Africa, they are worthy of recognition. This is because this once regal medieval city of 10,000 people was assembled stone by stone without mortar. In fact, the workmanship of the 12th century ancestors of the Shona people was so advanced for the architecture of this era that it dumbfounded European travelers into believing that the city was the work of foreign rulers. In the end, the age of the site and the builders were acknowledged as African and is now a site that reveals the skill and determination of the Shona people. 10. Rock art of Melodi Drakensberg, South Africa and Lesotho. The San Bushmen of Southern Africa are some of the oldest known inhabitants of the continent. High in the Melodi Drakensberg Mountains, along the border of South Africa and Lesotho, is one of the 5 World Heritage Sites in Africa that is recognized for both natural and cultural significance. Its rock art heritage, created over a period of 4,000 years, is a must-see for visitors to the Drakensberg Mountains. Some of the art was created as recent as 100 years ago, when the San were driven from the region. The rock art is colorful and shows scenes of the San hunting, dancing, fighting, gathering food, and performing rituals. The Sani Valley Nature Lodge is a wonderful place to call home while you explore all the Drakensberg Mountains have to offer. Thanks you for watching. Subscribe this channel for support next travel review.